Dr. Kiza Arima.
Both teams drew 1-1 full time before St. Marcus Secondary School prevailed on penalties by 3-2 goals. This was the first time for St. John Bosco Secondary School to qualify for knockouts competition as well as final stages. Both teams qualified for the Bunyoro region Uganda Secondary School Sports Association due 30th March to 4th April in Hoima, hosted by Bicha Secondary School. The top scorer of the tournament, Noah Amanyire, was given a pair of football boots after scoring 7 goals in 5 matches. As if this was not enough, the same school was crowned champions of Hoima City, Uganda Secondary School Sports Association, after defeating Kanoni Njagali Secondary Schools on 6-0. Both games were on Friday evening played at Hoima Boma Grounds with support from Microfinance Support Center. Dr. Emmanuel Aliba Kiza, the chairperson board Microfinance Support Center, said that they treasure the young and pledged to partner with them.
I stopped coming to your events because of indiscipline. I stopped watching football because of indiscipline. But now that you exhibited discipline from the beginning, I decided to come and join you. Now, if you continue like that from the beginning up to the end, I will always be joining you because I love you.
Johnson Kusima Bingana, the Hoima principal education officer, said that they are going to start hunting school head teachers who failed to participate in these co-curricular activities after learning that only 21 schools participated out of 31 secondary schools found in Hoima City.
Let's get to know co-curricular activities are mandatory and compulsory. Whereas we know that we have been in COVID, we can give you a leeway only this term, but come next term in athletics, we shall be there to hunt you and you will participate. I want to assure you, if you are prepared to work with us, please make all efforts possible to participate in co-curricular activities. Government organized program.
Report compiled by Ambrose Nwagaba Katoto for the news.